Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's my second flavors of the month because the month of February is over and done with. It pretty much flew by. I don't know if it wasn't really that much of a short month, but it definitely just, I can't believe we're already in March. I am a little late, thanks, with my flavors of the month this month. I'm not sure if it's just because we went out of town and that kind of threw me off, even though I had pre-recorded, but I guess this should have been done like 3 weeks ago, but it would have been like the second week of February, so I guess better late than never. I just want to share a few of my favorites this month. So let's get started. I'm gonna start with makeup, and it is the Too Faced Chocolate Bar Palette. So delicious. It does smell like chocolate. I just think it has everything I've needed, and I've picked it up more than usual this month, so I wanted to give it a thumbs up for the month of February. It has shimmers and sheens, and it has mattes, and it has a highlight, and it has everything you need in a palette. So this was pretty much my go-to for the month of February, but because it was Valentine's Day and it's chocolate. And for lipsticks, I'm gonna go with the LA Girl matte liquid lipsticks in the color Fleur. When I first looked these up online, because they weren't sold nearby me, this was the color that drew my attention. I was like obsessed with it, and then I finally ordered it, and it was like, I love it. It's pretty much everything I expected it to be. And let me see if I can grab it. It's not the same as Lolita, but it's kind of in the same family. It's that orangey, it's not orange, but like a taupey color? No, taupey's more purple. So this is Fleur. When I don't know what to wear, this is what I'm wearing. I just think it goes with so much. So it's definitely my go-to. For eyeliners, I'm gonna go with ColourPop Cosmetics in the color Workout. This is a dark green. What I like about this is that usually black is very intense and smoky. So the dark green will give me a little bit of darkness and just put it in my waterline quickly, but it doesn't look as intense. And I like that for during the day or when I go to work and I just want to put a little eyeliner, and it does really well at staying in place. I actually have this on today, and I also have the liquid, which I didn't really wing it out, but I have the pot. And this is in the color Workout as well, but it's just their, it's not liquid, it's cream. There you go, good job. Their cream eyeliner. This is a rather new product, but I've been using it all month, and I have to say that I love it. I have a little technique that I do for my eyelashes, and I curl my eyelashes, but I make sure to heat up the curling wand first. The eyelash curler? Curling wand. The eyelash curler first, I heat it up, I curl them, I put mascara, and then I curl them again. I know a lot of people say not to curl them after mascara, but my lashes don't curl. It's the only way to get them to curl and to stand up is to do it after mascara as well. What I like about this wand, it's not getting mascara on me. You do have to clean the excess off the edge, because for some reason it always comes out with a lot, is that it has like little bristles that go in and out, and it's kind of very unique, because if you go around you can see that it has a weird shape. I don't know how to explain it. And then it has a little tip, which is great for the bottom lashes so you don't make a mess. This is the CoverGirl Plumpify Blast Pro in very black, which I always go with like the darkest mascara that I can find. I'm gonna go with this brush, and this brush is part of the Sonia Kashuk collection from Target, and I use this for my highlight. I was using a different brush. I was using this brush, which is more of a tapered, this is by e.l.f., a small tapered, and I felt like I wasn't getting highlight like I wanted. I really wanted to glow, and I decided to try just a different brush. I know this is probably an eye brush, and I just kind of, I don't have a mirror, but go like this, go like this, and then with the excess I go up a little and I create that little C shape. And I absolutely love it. I've been using this for a few weeks now, and I wouldn't go back to this now. I just, this does so much more for me than this. So I've moved on. Sorry, Elf. And to clean my brushes, I use Family Soap Maker since 1858. This is Dr. Bronner's 18-in-1 Hemp Lavender Pure Castile Soap. As you can see, I've gone through most of the bottle. It's done. I need a new one. I really like this soap. It leaves my brushes very soft. The only thing is that you really have to make sure you rinse off all the soap. All the soap. All of it. Because your brush will stay with like a little bit of soap and it has like a weird texture and you just can't use it. So make sure that if you use this, or if you use any soap, you want to make sure you take all the soap off the brushes. But in this month, especially because I was traveling and with Valentine's Day and just all the makeup tutorials and stuff, I make sure to clean my brushes all the time. You don't want to get dirty brushes. And then it's, if you have a dirty brush, it doesn't pick up the product the same. And if you have a dark, dirty brush and you're trying to pick up a light color, it's going to make a big mess. I've done that. And then the last product I've been loving this month is the Vaseline Spray and Go Moisturizer. This is in Cocoa Radiant Non-Greasy. The month of February has destroyed my skin. And with that being said, I have made sure to put on extra moisturizer. So what I love about this is that I don't really have to get my hands all up in there. I can just get out of the shower, spray this, and my skin absorbs it, and that's it. It does make a little bit of a mess though. So you might want to stand over a little rug or something, because it's a spray. See? It does spray everywhere. Now I'm gonna have like a light cast of lotion on the floor, and you will slip. Because I know someone who almost slipped on it, and he didn't find it as amusing as I did. But I've been loving this, and it's just easy to use. Yeah, holds 4 inches from skin and spray over arms, legs, and body in a continuous motion. Oh, quickly rub into skin and go. I don't rub into skin. I just let it sit on my skin. Have you guys seen this? With my hair being extremely long, it gets knotted, even if I'm just wearing it down. And this is the Tangle Teezer. It's just a Tangle Teezer? Yeah, it's just a Tangle Teezer. And it's meant to comb out your hair without breaking it, and I absolutely love it. So just go through it. I always start at the bottom and work my way up. In case I have any knots, I don't completely pull them out and pull all the hair out that's in the knot as well. I shut a lot, guys. Sorry. I've had this for a few months already, and I don't think I ever spoke about it, but it's what I use whenever I'm combing my hair or brushing my hair out. It's my favorite. And it comes with this cute little thing, a little cover. So if you travel with it, the bristles won't get messed up. The bristles are like in a zigzag, and you have taller ones and shorter ones. And I absolutely love that. Makeup wipes. I try different makeup wipes all the time whenever I go down to the drugstore or work. They usually only bring 25, so I go through them rather quickly. And I picked up a different brand. I think I have it. Let's see which ones I picked up. I'm not sure. I picked up the Nivea Gently Cleansing Wipes, and I disliked them. By the time I got to the third wipe, they were already dry, and I would make sure to close the bag, and it was terrible. So I picked up the Garnier Skin Naturals Fresh Cleansing Cloths. Oh, normal to dry skin are these. Enriched with rose extract and vitamin E. This is my second bag, and I love them. So I will continue probably to buy these. And I just wanted to say one favorite, which is not part of makeup, but it is my favorite thing to watch at the moment, and it's Community. I'm so obsessed with it. I think we're in season 3. We just pretty much binge watch it all the time, every weekend. Huh?
Season 4.
Oh, season 4. Season 4. Already? That makes me sad. There's only one more season. I don't know what we're going to watch after. But I absolutely love, like, just short comedy TV. So those were my favorites for the month of February. I think I named everything I was loving. Don't forget to hit the red button and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next one. Bye.